This is what addiction looks like.
Charts, I'm setting up camp, pounding my stakes, I put on my tent, shoot for the stars, they fall in my head, stick to my guns, I don't even flinch, can push all you want, they moving in next.
Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Wallhacks, aka Trevor, and someone posted on one of my videos that they would really like to see a kit breakdown of what I use when I go pew and shoot some kids. So today I'm just going to go over what I use, what I run with, and my financial bad decisions. So up first, this is the kit that I always wear every single time I go airsofting. This is a Blue Force Gear Plate Maximus, I believe. That's what it is at its base. What I run on it is just standard, I think, Valken 3 mag pouch. And then on top I have a Blue Force Gear mag pouch system, which is just buttery smooth. Other than that, I have an admin's pouch for all my Allen keys that I need for adjusting hop up or quick field strip. On the back, I run a Haley Strategic Flat Pack. This is an amazing investment. I absolutely love it. It is probably like a third the cost of a GMR mini map, and I think it's a lot cooler. The cool thing about this is there's a zipper that runs all around the entire backpack, so you can change it from a one-day backpack to like a three-day backpack just by popping it out. Also, I run a core ice plate for the rear plate. I love the core ice plate. It keeps me nice and cool. Also keeps me hydrated on the field, which is incredibly important. The front, I just run just a normal sappy plate that's just foam, just to keep the shape of it. But that is it for my kit. Sorry, camera died there for a second, but that's my kit. I love it. It's a little on the heavy side. I think it fully kitted up, water, tank, everything. It's about like 25 to 30 pounds, so it's not light by any means, but I love it. I always use it. Never had an issue with it. On to my horrible financial decisions. So, asking me about what my favorite gun is like asking a parent what their favorite child is. Don't really have an answer, but I'll go through them one by one. So this is my Bingo Airsoft Custom Classic Army M249/Mark 46. So I got this a year ago on my 21st birthday, but essentially it is a Classic Army M249 and it has a Bingo Airsoft Works HPA Polar Star in it. It is one of Bingo's prototype M249s. I got this from someone back home, and they knew a guy who knew a guy who had one, and he wanted to sell it, and I shot him an offer, and now it's with me. So far, nothing too crazy done with it. I still gotta put some work into it in terms of the hop-up system and all that, but generally I run this gun. I bring it to Milsims if I really want to run an LMG, and I also bring it to Airsoft Barracks. But so far, I mean, this is just a one-of-one gun. I absolutely love running it, but I hate spending so much money on BBs because this thing just eats BBs for breakfast. But this is one of my favorites. I mean, never gonna get rid of this thing. I just need to put a little bit more work into the hop-up and barrel setup, and then it should be just shooting lasers. All right. What's next? All right, I'll talk about this one next. So this is my carbon fiber KWA, KWA SR10/KR7. This is what I usually run at battalion, what I started to run initially at an indoor field. Built this gun out of just some receivers and parts I had laying around. I had an extra gearbox laying around from an old DMR HPA build that I had. And then I figured I should put it together for some speed style play. This is fully built and upgraded from parts from Airsoft Barracks. The guys over there are phenomenal. I always get my parts through them. But this I actually just sold to one of my good friends. As I said, the base is a KWA, has a 2GX gearbox, full gate Titan build. This carbon fiber rail is from Tap Airsoft, also a fantastic company. Haley Strategic flashlight, the Vesky Tracer unit, cheap Amazon red dot that I hand polished to get the nice silver look. On to the next. See another good one. All right, let's go over this one. This one is the newest addition to my collection. This is an Echo One AK-74U. Got this from one of the guys in the club that I know. Put a lot of TLC into it. A lot of the screws were kind of stripped out. I had to fix those, re-tap them, but I always wanted an AK. This is my cheat AK, but I wanted an actual one. So this started as an Echo One with polymer furniture. I bought LCT wood furniture and took a Dremel to it to make it fit. Did a couple burning action on it to make it look nice and good. This is pretty much complete too. It has a motor, gate tightened gearbox setup, full compression, all that good stuff. And then all I need now is a Vesky Tracer unit whenever those decide to come back in stock, hopefully. But you'll notice I don't have a rail mount on here. Since it's a 74U, I didn't want to get the side mount because then I wouldn't be able to pop open the dust cover and put a battery in there. So I was kind of left with thinking about getting a Zeneco red dot for the front sight like they have in Tarkov. But I didn't feel like paying for that much money for it. So instead I just took a Dremel to the rear sight posts and then extended the clamp channel on the red dot. And then what do you know? It's a nice red dot. It's nice and straight. The actual sights aren't. Thank you, Echo One. But this is also one of my favorite builds. I really love running it. I gotta run it a little bit more to get some nice testing into it, but we'll see more of this in the future. All right, you all know this one. This is my KWA MP7 gas blowback with power-up suppressor. I got this gun, I think last year, also from somebody in the club, because I always wanted an MP7. This is, anytime there's an MP7 in COD, it's what I'm running. So, running the mill KWA MP7 with the TAP Airsoft drum mag. I didn't feel like spending $300 some odd on mags for this gun, so I just caved and bought the drum mag for it. All in all, it's bone stock, pretty much. If you know KWA MP7s, you know their buckings like to swell up. So the only thing I've done to this is just change the bucking. Whoever had this, two people before me upgraded the bolt and that ended up breaking. Not from my error. I know not to run these hot with the taps, but I had to get a new replacement bolt straight from Hong Kong, replaced it, lubed everything up, works like a charm. Also what I did is I Dremeled the stock rails to have your classic more than just two position stock. I felt like this was a lot better to the shoulder, but KWA MP7, you can't beat this thing. This has phenomenal range for what it is, and I just love running it. All right, next. This is one of my rarest guns. This is a KWA gas blowback Vector. This was made for a brief period of time way back in 2012. Production of these Vectors had to get shut down because KWA actually never obtained the license to produce them. So I got this off of a guy in Hop Up. He was just dying to get rid of it, and I know how much these are worth, and he sold it to me for about half of what I would have sold it for because he just wanted to get rid of it. It's great shape. I color filled most of the laser etched, I laser etched most of the markings, but again, this is a bone stock build. Parts for this are incredibly difficult to find because it was made for such a short period of time. So I don't want to upgrade anything just in case it breaks. This is going to be bone stock. Also, it's a great gun. I love it. The only complaint I have is most of the bolt stuff is up front, just like the real steel Vector. So it's very front heavy when I use it. So So it gets tiring after a little bit, but I mean, you cannot complain with this. I run this every now and then. Be really careful not to break it, but I think this is just one that's going to be a nice wall piece, and I'll just use it occasionally. Also, my favorite, I always wanted one of these. They were huge back in 2012. I knew a guy who had one, but not many of them were ever sold, so I'm lucky to have one in the first place. I've only seen one other one in the wild, but. All right, y'all recognize this one. This is what you see in most of my videos when I go play at Battalion. This is my custom Ronin 47 limited edition, Drifter edition by KWA. I picked this one up, I think September or October when these came out. I got the Drifter edition because it came with a shirt and a sweatshirt and some cool swag with it. But as soon as I used it, I knew I wanted to upgrade it. I really like how compact it is, even though it's like an AK. It's just something unique. I built a bunch of M4s. I don't want to build another M4. I wanted something different. So this is what I picked up. This is, again, fully upgraded by, well, with parts from Airsoft Barracks. I do all my work myself, but Gate Titan, gears, you know, compression, the whole nine. It's got a nice barrel in it. Flat hop the original bucking, because that's the only one it liked. But also it has the option one brushless high torque motor. I cannot speak, and like, this motor is phenomenal. It has amazing torque, amazing speed, and it's just phenomenal. It doesn't generate heat, it's brushless, it is fantastic. The only thing I watch out for is make sure you don't shred your gearbox with a premature engagement, and you'll be golden. I mean, this motor is amazing. I had a 22K in it before, and again, I mean, 22K, 12-to-1 gears, you're perfect, snappy trigger response, but I wanted to test the brushless out, and I love it. It's amazing. Strike Industries M-Lock foregrip, Noveska KX3, Vortex Crossfire. I run Vortex Crossfires on most of my guns, like on my MP7, Mark 18, and now this one. The Drifter Edition means that the rails and the trigger are this acid green. This is anodized, and I wanted to get a nice color, but the paint that I had didn't really match it. So I'm debating sending these off for Cerakote to Tap Airsoft, where they have a really nice acid green that I could get just to complete the look, because it's very slightly off. Guess the only thing else is it's a normal version 2 gearbox, version 2.5, as KWA uses, has the adjustable FPS system, quick change spring system. It just takes these proprietary AK mags. And then I guess to round out this one, I had a Night Evolution red dot, or Night Evolution flashlight, sorry, on it that I also got from Barracks. But this is the gun you mostly see when I play at Battalion, because this is, it's a nice compact package, it's easy to manipulate in your hands, it's just wonderful. Last but not least, this is my Mark 18 kinda Block 3 build. This is the first AEG I actually ever built by myself. Again, full K Titan, 22K motor, gears, compression, everything with that. But got all these parts from Barracks. First gun I ever built. This one actually did break because it was my fault. So I had to rebuild half of it. But this is the gun I always run at Milsims. This is my gun that'll never die. It'll never break. This is, I could drop this off a roof of a building and have full confidence it's gonna work for me. So this is what I use when I go to more serious games or Airsoft Barracks, X-Plex. But generally when I go to a Milsim, you'll see me with this gun most of the time. I did the stippling myself. I'm gonna cut this grip a little shorter to make it look a little bit better, but as a Venom Tech, like, knockoff Ergy barrel or Ergy rail on it. Fake Repro SOCOM 556 suppressor. Again, Vortex red dot, because I love them. And then just some PTS furniture. Love this thing. This is by far my best ranging gun. The range on this thing is absolutely ridiculous. Feels good in the hands. It's fun to use. So this is my Milsim gun. Phenomenal. As you can see, another KWA. This one was built out of an SR10 that I had laying around and just swapped the upper receiver, did, you know, everything else. But I have a lot of KWAs. My favorite company. I think they're amazing. I got KWA Vector, MP7, Ronin 47, a weird mashup of old KWA generations, and then a full KWA KM4 build. Love the company. If you want to get into airsoft and you're at the intermediate level, 100%, pick yourself up a KWA. No doubt about it. But that rounds up my collection. I think in the future, I think every week I can do a under the hood breakdown where I actually take this, like let's say this one for example, talk more about it, what I have done to it, how I built it out, a couple shooting tests, how does it sound, how does it perform, and just stuff like that. I'll do a more in-depth view of all these guns, primarily this, my Mark 18, Ronin 47, and then my AK. But I'll do a under the hood series for this, bumper to bumper, as one would say. But thank you for watching. Really appreciate it. Glad I could share with you my toys and my guns. And I hope to see you all on the field at Battalion or X-Plex or Barracks, wherever I may see you. Appreciate it. Thank you.